Who is gonna get exposed tonight?
Every Namibian is entitled to my opinion. Before we get to that story, guys, I just realized that I've been saving you guys tea without a mug. That's why I, Namibia's Hot Tea, came out with my own mug line. Yes, Namibia's Hot Tea, these mugs right here. These are the mugs I'll be selling from today onwards, you guys. And please, guys, you cannot call yourself Namibia's Hot Tea fan if you don't buy your own Namibia's Hot Tea mug that you can use to sip tea when you're watching my YouTube channel. Move the call. Like, this is the mug that you're supposed to use. The prices of these mugs is $100 if you're in Windhoek. The original price, the actual price of it is $100 if you're in Windhoek, and you come and pick it up from me personally from the company. Otherwise, if you're in Windhoek but cannot, don't have time to pick it up, you can order it for 130 and it can be delivered to you and to everyone else all over the country. It's $100 for the cup plus $65 for the courier fee. So in total is $165, guys. Please support your girl Namibia's Hot Tea. And to be honest, my personal favorite mugs, yes, you can see there, that's the front and the back. My personal favorite is this one right here, the one that says that it's not gossip if it's true. And it really is not gossip if it's true. And I'm a messy bitch that lives for drama. And this one of, I swear to spill the tea, the whole tea, and nothing but the tea. Those are my three personal favorite mugs, guys. Please support your girl. Please, if you want to order, please WhatsApp me on here right here, and please, and put in your order, and you'll get your mug within 1 to 2 business days. Akotoshiri. Anyway, I have two stories for you guys. The first one, Kabweka Makili's former manager Abed, accused of scamming an artist out of 1.5. And the second story is Top Linus alleging in her song that Top Cherry stole or copied her songs. Okay, guys, we have a lot to discuss today. Okay, let's start with the Abed and Mabuza story. You guys know Abed. Abed is Kabweka Makili's former manager. Kabweka Makili came out and exposed him for scamming him out of his money. So anyways, Abed has been in the industry offering artists his services. He's apparently a graphic designer. Anyways, Andrew Rap magazine revealed that apparently Abed owes Mabuza 1.5. Mabuza is an artist and apparently went to Abed for some services. By the way, can you talk about how sexy his name is? It sounds so risque, like a mafia type of a name. I love the name. It's so sexy. Like, saying it just makes me want to fall in love. Oh, anyways, let's continue. Let's not drift away from the story. But anyways, I love the name Mabuza. It's very sexy, very gangsterish. That's why I'm even shocked that Abed will scam somebody that goes by the name Mabuza, because they person, he sounds like a honcha man. The person has a honcha, and I'm like, anyways, Unwrapped magazine, but Mabuza went to speak to Unwrapped magazine where he made these allegations, where they reported saying Abed owes me 1.5 Mabuza. So the article goes like, quite artist and actor Mabuza wants his money from Kabweka Makili's former manager Abed, who recently jumped on the board to promote Exit and Conjure's Diviele album. He claimed that Abed robbed him of his money by delivering unprofessional work done on his art cover for a fee of 1.5, which made him end up taking his business elsewhere. And apparently after this happened, Mabuza tried to ask his money back from Abed Ashashi. The quality of work that was done was really not up to standard. So better Abed had been running and whatsoever. And you guys know that Namibia's Hot Tea is very nosy and I love stories. So I DM'd Mabuza just to get the whole, because I was like, okay, Abed, really? Because he's now on Exit side, and I'm like, okay, did he really scam it? Like, you know. Anyways, I talked to Mabuza and I had this conversation with him. Let's go through my conversation with Mabuza. And honestly, okay, I'm not sure that you can say scamming is the right word, but Abed really need to return Mabuza's money. Shashi, the work he did for the boy was substandard, zero balance. One, he really need to return the money. One, anyways, let's go through the conversation I had with Mabuza. By the way, love still the name, so sexy. So I went on Instagram and as I said, DM'd him. This is my conversation with him. He said, Mabuza, I just saw your interview about being ripped off by Abed. Can you tell me more? He replies to that saying, nothing mad. Just as I stated in Unwrap, I heard he ran to the north after he heard I'm looking for him. It doesn't help. I'll still find him. I'm not the one of his zoppers. So I asked Namo. So he did a half finished job and ran away. And then he replies to that said, he did some B artwork. You can read that for himself there. But then let's go through the graphic work that Abed did for Mabuza. Look, this is one there. Like, really? Abed, did you really? Is this really worth 1.5? Even I, who hasn't done graphic knows, graphic design, knows that this is substandard. This is zero balance. This guy didn't even bother to try. And look at the other one. I don't know. This is the only one that he designed. Like, what is this? Abed, the question can be... Abed, what nonsense is this? Is this really worth one? Like, how do you charge somebody 1.5 for this nonsense? And now, so Mabuza decided to go on to another graphic artist and look at what that person designed. This. Can you see the difference? Look at what Abed designed and look what Sheila Duman Hari Rantunaiman. Like, Abed. I'm sorry, and I'm sure Kabweka Makili, wherever he is, he's probably saying, I already told the scammers, he's just tapping his feet. And guys, please, whatever you do, avoid Abed. Really do. Shashi? Ugh. Anyways, Mabuza even claimed that apparently Abed made Twitter suspend his account because Mabuza was going after Abed there. So I don't know. And even when I saw it, look at what I replied to there. I was like, damn, are you serious? His work is BS. Unless you're pulling my leg. What? In what world did you think this was okay? He's full of... Ugh. Then I asked, can I do... Then he said, obviously you guys know before I do a story, I have to ask permission, especially when I'm interviewing a person. Mm-hmm. So Abed, really, what do you guys think? Is this work really worth 1.5 or... Anyways, I hope Abed returns the Gabois money, and I hope any upcoming artist, please avoid Abed. Look at what he's providing there. You can see his work there. Please avoid him. He's a scammer. Kabweka Makili already warned us, so you don't need anything more from there. Guys, let's get into the second story, where Lioness is alleging in her new song that Top Cherry copies her song or something along those lines. Guys, Lioness snapped in her new song. Damn, this bitch really did snap, and I'm in love with the new song and the way this girl raps. By the way, I'm obsessed. I've been listening to this song over 100 times. Oh yes, I'll probably be able to rap for you guys next week at this song. Ashashi, this song is fire. Anyways, I cannot sing, but you guys... Okay, let me bring you back to scratch. You guys remember that Top Cherry accused Lioness of stealing her manager? And Lioness wanted them to talk this out in private Amara. You know, Top Cherry did not want. And after that, I thought Top Cherry and Lioness were cool as she. Top Cherry had been going on live and just mentioning Lioness. I want like this one right here, where she was asked to pick artists that can perform with Beyonce. And Top Cherry mentioned Lioness. So I thought no, these people were cool. Mara, do you guys remember when I told that Top Cherry was on fire that time when she made those homophobic comments? Uh-huh. That day when people were attacking Top Cherry, Lioness went on her Twitter account and uploaded this thing. All I'm saying is every dog has its day, the day that Top Cherry was being attacked. So you can see she's only obviously referring to Top Cherry there. So that's when I knew that Nokcha, things were not cool. Anyways, Lioness really, by the way, Lioness is inspiring me to go full time with with this, Oshiri, my passion, this is which is going to be being, you know, talking about being an entertainment whatsoever. I really want to quit my job and do this full time. I'm kidding you guys, not. I just want to come up with a way to monetize this for me to be able to earn a living properly from it. But if you analyze the words from Lioness's news track, Superstar, by the way, please go and listen to it, stream it. You will see that Nokcha, she's inferring. She didn't mention the name, but you can clearly say that you can clearly see that she's referring to Top Cherisha. She Top Cherisha is the only female artist that she kind of had a problem with her. Anyways, what she said there is this. Just these two lines where she said, "Don't bring the beef unless it's filet mignon. I don't F with her. She's stealing, copying my songs." Can you guys see there? Stealing and copying my songs. So she's alleging that Top Cherry steals and copies her song. To be honest, I haven't heard of those rumors. Mara, if Linus is alleging it or whatsoever, then it must be true. It must be true. And you guys know Linus writes her own rap songs. So she obviously, she knows what she meant. And somebody on Twitter picked that up and tweeted this saying, why didn't you tell me that Linus dropped the diss track? You people are not real friends, aha, real friends. And then Linus replies to that saying, ha 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 ha, laughing emoji. And if you go on her like tweets, tweets that she liked this tweet that's alleging that it's a diss track and it's to Meme Winya. So clearly Linus, and it is like, do you guys believe that Top Cherry still stole the copies and whatever? So to be honest, I don't know, because I haven't heard of those rumors. But if Linus is saying it, who are we to deny the queen? If the queen is saying it, then it must be true. So like, Top Cherry muto hayak geng karo antu, I don't know. Anyways, what do you guys think about, do you guys believe it? Let me know in the comments down below. And you guys notice me, Top Cherry has had problems with a lot of artists. Like a lot of artists, she really looks like somebody who's very problematic to me. And if you follow this, I've been telling the Nokcha, like Top Cherry is a problematic artist. So this shouldn't be something new to you guys. Anyways, what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments down.